It is the problem and lacking of the charging infrastructure. This is the two major concern for the Indian government right now. And 10,000 electric vehicle that is introduced by Tata and Mahindra, it is the just an initiation, just the incentives by the EESL, Energy Efficiency Service Limited. So they have tendered and sent Tata Motors and this Mahindra produced 10,000 electric vehicle. And some others, private like Suzuki and Toyota, they are team to bring electric vehicle in India by 2020. So currently, in all the Kias and others, they are coming with the electric vehicle options. So in Ola and Indian Oil, first they have launched the charging infrastructure. But in Delhi, if you find that at every government building and like POS area, there are charging infrastructure. But still in the like Banaras, such kind of the city, there is no charging infrastructure. In Delhi, there is there. So we are. I am also purchasing electric vehicle. So
purchase are going to purchase.
Purchase are going to purchase. No, going to purchase. I just booked. Take out. Tata. In India, actually, we are promoting this thing. For Tata and Mahindra. So
what is the average of full charging?
One full charging, they are claiming that 200. 200, but it will not come on 200. It will 150, 100.
I think what I think is that while people are using the electric, but that is really doesn't have that much power as compared to the
performance point of view, it is not behind with the IC vehicles. The torque level, the power level, it is much better than the IC vehicles. But the only problem is that the cost.
For the limited kilometers.
No. There are a lot of the things there. Na? It will state of charge, state of health. They will say about these things. If there is a this amount of the charge, so they will providing the power ups. So it will inform by the vehicle to the users. You have left with the 20% of the charging. So you have to move for the charging at nearby whatever the energy operators. Okay, but performance is much better than the this IC.
He is trying to say that when the vehicle is.
I understand. Give a vehicle it 100% and 20%. There is no difference in that case. Because battery is working on the, suppose, 48 volt, 78 volt, 20 amperes current will be there. So it will calculate automatically na, how much power it will be required, volt into current, 20 ampere. So it will calculate. So in that way, it will say that within 10 minutes, you are going to... voltage decreases, somehow powers will be constant flowing. Depends upon the torque speed, what the motor controller and what is the, but battery will giving the constant power. As soon as there will be the some criteria developed by this R&D team. What is the, if suppose 20% left, so how much power will be required? If 30% left, how much power will be required? So it will be there.
There must be something like when to replace the battery, whether the battery is working or not. When to replace your battery?
It will show on your like.
At 2 days and electrics. And my father is using that.
Okay.
Initially, is it possible? After charging it, it ran around 30-40 kilometers.
Okay.
But now, what is happening? We are charging it, charged. It's coming to zero battery.
Very soon. Very soon. I understand. Maybe the problem is the battery.
How are we going to check?
That is the advance of that. State of charge. State of that is the machine learning IoT is coming. Right? In that way. Key, it will show what is the state of charge, what is the state of health of your battery. Actually, with the charge, the cycle of the battery is the 2500 cycles. it is the ideal 2500 times you can fully charge. 2500. But over the times it will decrease. It depends upon the fluctuations of your voltage, current where you are charging. It will also deteriorate the condition of your battery. And driving, all the things. It depends on the circumstances where you are using that.
Average life of the battery
will decrease over the time.
At max, for the how much time once a battery?
2500. It will get written on your battery. 2500 cycles it can charge. So generally for 5 to 6 years. It depends upon usage. It depends upon usage. If you are using daily 300 kilometer, or you can in city generally mostly 50 kilometer office then house. So 50 kilometers it will 6 to 7 years.
Depends upon kilometer or cycles.
No cycles. Cycles.
What people can say that on the term that if you take the example, they will present is e-riksha. Okay. If we go by the e-riksha, when we ride a slope, very slow, then there is a problem. They will ride a lot of slow. Okay.
So the problem is that
the road is not so
smooth. I understand. The problem is that the motor and battery both. Motor has the capacity producing such kind of the torque. Right.
Right now we don't have such a hybrid or efficient battery.
Battery and motor. That is coming from the China. That's why we are doing that in our country. It will be developed as per our condition. They have developed as per their condition, and we are purchasing them. So we have to develop to our country because the temperature in China is different than India. 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. So it depends also the battery life. When you are charging your battery at 50 degrees Celsius and when you are charging your battery at 20 degrees Celsius, that battery life will be depends on that.
Because till now, right now we are talking about battery life, performance. On slope, on battery.
That is why I am saying.
This is in one lane. Water remains there. Water fed up. The road fed
up. Power is constant. Power. There is no issue at battery side. The power will be not given by the battery.
Motor
producing the torque. Motor produces the torque, na? So motor we have to design and develop as per our condition.
Right now, currently battery is getting itself a major challenge. And if you develop a higher power, then we have to develop a bigger wheel.
All things we have to change.
All the things
you have to change accordingly. Motor, controller, and powertrain. All the things you have to change. Right. There is a requirement of this skill development in electric vehicles.
Even I think you have the person like you.
But I think the UP government has also some EV policy there.
But there will be no bonus or return.
Okay. But most of the states, they have given such kind of incentive, like Maharashtra, Karnataka.
For me, I have no return. The major problem
is road. The major problem is road. But road, who can do it? This is the problem of not only here in UP, it is for whole country. And that's why, according to our road condition, according to our condition, we have to develop the technology for anything. whatever the main technology, even our most of the system like in mobile, everything what we are using, electronics and IT applications, they are importing, we are importing. And import is being done. They have developed outside as per their condition. And they are not even reliable in that sense.
I think, sir, in the first complete the slide, then we
will... Right, right. Yeah. Why not moving? So if you see the this condition, Indian condition, so out of around in 2016, 70, 21 million vehicles has been sold, and out of that, around 80% is two-wheeler, three-wheeler. Most of the country, developed country, they are developing their technology, they are developing, they are setting up the charging infrastructure, and because of their condition, because they use the four-wheelers maximum, right? We mostly use the two-wheeler, 80%, two-wheeler and three-wheeler. So we have to develop the things according to that. That's why I'm here, some data I have mentioned here, that this in India, above 1.5 million in 15 lakhs car. 15 lakhs car, you can see 1.3 lakhs only they have sold. Right? So it is very much around 15% of the total car. Right? So we cannot just follow whatever the other country doing. We have to do the things, setting up the charging infrastructure or battery development or motor, all the things development according to our requirement. So if we talk about this EV technology, so any EV can be broadly divided into these four systems: mechanical system, electrical, ICT, and sensing and control system. So in mechanical system, what are the challenges is like area of research in the mechanical system is the which kind of the material is being used. Because the efficiency of any vehicle depends upon the weight, right? So you have to find out the composite materials, what kind of the alloy materials for this. So research is going in that direction to this vehicle structure. And what are the aerodynamics, mechanical design of the vehicles? So this is the area of research in the mechanical system. In electrical system, that is, it consists battery pack, traction motor, and this battery charger. And most important part is the BMS, battery thermal management system, it is generally called. So battery management system. So in motor and controller, if you see motor and controller, so there are many kind of the motors that is being developed, but in our e-rickshaw and e-scooter, generally we use this BLDC motor. So, but for high powers, if you go for this, we have to move the AC motors. So in that sense, we have to move permanent magnet synchro PMSM motor. PMSM motor, actually the efficiency performance is much more in comparison to the BLDC and the things. The structure of BLDC and permanent magnet motor is same. Only the control algorithm and the magnets, number of magnets for the controlling of the motor so that it will have a good torque, good power efficiency. So, but the cost of PMSM motor is a very important parameter. Actually, the number of magnets increased. So the cost move ahead. So this PERMA PMSM motor for high power, it is generally costly. And we are importing these magnets from the China. Here there is no magnet. So that's why PMSM motor is called a BLDC in e-rickshaw. It is generally developed. It is also, we are importing 99% from the China, but it is somehow less costly in comparison to the PMSM motor. And this motor controller is a very important subsystem of the this powertrain for conversion of different AC-AC, DC-DC converter. So it should also be compact and low cost, and the efficiency of the motor controller is also is a very important parameter to just find out the overall efficiency of the vehicle. And for the hilly region, whatever the slope you are saying that, so some regenerative kind of braking is also being introduced in the new generation of the electric vehicle, where you can restore this electric power back to the battery once you moving on slope. So there are different kind of DC-DC converters and EV chargers. So I'm coming on that. So if you see this EV powertrain development, so we were discussing that domain expertise. There in India, the problem is domain expertise in that direction. So skill development in that direction will be also needed by the government of India, and we are working on that. Domain expert in that direction. And there are different simulation tools, modeling tool chains. So all things we have to convert from the ICE to electric vehicle. So there, the calibration, configuration of the design for this EV powertrain will be totally different in comparison to the ICE vehicle. So in that direction, these are the development challenges for EV powertrain development. So this is the battery pack. This is a very important thing, that is the lithium-ion battery technology that is currently being used in every battery. So battery pack, if you see the cost-wise, their contribution, so material and chemical contribute 40%, cell manufacturing 30%, battery pack assembly 30%. So where we are, in India, we are doing only battery pack assembly 30%. Cell manufacturing, we are not doing. It is directly coming from outside. Some kind of one or two companies, they have just come up for making the cell of this lithium-ion battery. Just so within 2-3 years, we are also will be manufacturing cell for the battery. And material and chemicals, we are all the things we are importing. That's why recycling of this is being done by the country. Once it is supposed imported from the China, so by recycling 95% we can recycle back to the lithium and nickel manganese, which is the rare earth materials which is not found in the India. So and this cell manufacturing, basically the efforts in finding the fine balance between the chemistry process and the cost is very critical. So cell manufacturing is generally not currently, some institution like IIT Madras, ISC, they are working on that. There is you might be knowing that Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala, the IIT Madras, he's a very key person in that direction. So he's working with me. Actually, I have funded him 100 crore. They are going to produce millions of the motors, different power rating. So starting, so professor are coming, actually.
I am under a few challenges for premises. Before I was talking to sir, he said to make a project to sir, or rather,
yeah, I'm coming on that point. In last I will come, how you can come forward, right? I will discuss. Ajay, you are from electrical. Okay. So you are, I think, of that. So I will discuss about that. And if you see this battery, three kind of the battery generally used. So first is that the most important lithium, nickel, manganese, cobalt oxide. Acha. Okay. So NMC, LTO, LFP. So initially we started with the NMC battery, which has the very high specific energy. This is a very important parameter. That is the 250 watt hour per kg. And its cost is less in comparison to the other LTO, LFP. But the problem is that it is the slow charging. So around 7 to 8 hours is required for the charging of the, and it is temperature sensitive. We cannot charge and we cannot use at high temperature, like in Rajasthan, where temperature goes beyond 50 degrees Celsius. So the battery's life cycles degraded. And LTO is a good alternative all kind of the battery, but the cost is a very important because it's fast charging around 20 minutes. Because as a user, we generally wants that our battery will be charged within a minute. So LTU is the best option, but the cost is a problem. And its specific energy is also less in comparison. LFP is the middle of this NMC and LTO. So, but in India, currently we are focusing on the NMC battery. And these are the other alternate fuel sources where the research is going on. And some prototype has been come like hydrogen fuel cell, lithium sulfur, graphene super capacitor, redox flow battery, aluminum graphite battery have come up. One company Login, they have come up with the prototype. We have very high specific energy, 16,000 watt power per kg, but the cost is the problem. So all the working on that direction. So if we this EV component development, so electric motor, we have just required to have high efficiency, performance, durability, and battery. In case of battery, safety, BMS, and life cycle should be more. So in electrical, the area of research is the battery technology, where we can work. That is a battery technology, traction motor, which kind of motor is used, what should be the specification of the motor, or electronics module like inverter, DC-DC converter, charger. So these are the charging in charging standards that is set by the IEC, you know, International Electrotechnical Commission, which defines the standards for this charging infrastructure. So there are IC 60309 621. This is the slow chargers, and fast charger, that is a DC-DC charger, CHAdeMO. This is Japan based fast charging standards. And in India, this two chargers they have already installed. That is, one is the AC slow charger and DC low power fast charging. And for that EC high power fast charging, it is under consideration by the government of India for approval. So as a ICT components, you know, along with this, we are also moving to the autonomous vehicle. So autonomous vehicle, lot of the sensors will be required, and all the sensors data will go to the server. I mean, through machine learning, they will decide what is the where the signals to be given. So according to their application, sensors for safety, diagnostic, convenience, environment monitoring. So ICT and infotainment is also a very important part of this electric vehicle. So where we can work on that. So this basically all the signals will go to the electronic control unit, ECU, and then ECU will decide what where the signal, what is the requirement of the users. So accordingly, the signals will be given to that system. So CPS, as I was discussing about CPS system. So basically sensing, then computing, processing will be done. And through machine learning, we will cognize that what is the requirement and then communicated accordingly. So it is basically the CPS system comes in the autonomous vehicle. We are thinking and we have given some projects in that direction, autonomous vehicle also, but it is very less. You know, in Indian environment, autonomous is a very tough thing. Google has, Google has produced autonomous vehicle, and they have in the US, they have on the road, they have field trials and other things. So some autonomous is coming also there. So this CPS is basically, that is the advanced version of this current electric vehicle that will decide the state of charge, state of health, state of function, and make intelligent decision actually to respond the requirement in real time. So real time, what is the condition of the battery, real time, what is the condition of the motor, and what will be next few hours. So this will be defined by the CPS system. So here the role of the IT and these things comes. So EV safety is very, because we are using the battery, high power battery here. So safety is very in flood cases, in like EMC is also problem, lot of the signal sensors. So electromagnetic interferences problems will be there. So we have to take care of that. So in whatever I have discussed, that is the EV technology. But in India, what should be the strategy to move ahead for the in EV? So as you know that in general IC vehicles, we just see that kilometer ki kitna deti hai, ek liter mein kitna deti hai. So similarly here, watt hour per kilometer. So kitna power kharch ho raha hai ek kilometer mein. We have to reduce that. So in last six months, in e-autos, which generally have the capacity of 4 to 5 kilowatt hour battery, so 70 to it moved down to 45 and 50 because of the research and development. So in e-buses generally have 100 kilo, they have produced 900 watt hour per kilometer battery. And one more option is that we have to just split out the battery into the smaller size and swapping kind of things. This is the concept given by the professor Sol Junjunwala, that is swapping should be come in the India. Suppose your battery will be it will be discharged fully, right? So just go to the energy operator, give them a charge battery, take and insert in your just plugged in your vehicles and move ahead. So the cost may also come down once the vehicle will be purchased without battery, and battery will be provided by the energy operator. Getting my point? Automatically 50% cost will be reduced. But the battery, this is the Niti Aayog is thinking about this, ki this battery kind of things, all the petrol pumps will be converted as energy operators, and they will provide the battery based on the nominal charges. For one full charge, they will give the battery, suppose 25 kilowatt hour battery, 200, 500, whatever the charge will be there. So it comes for in electric vehicle, generally what the cost calculated is 1.5 to 1 rupees per kilometer. So, that's why, na? So that we are taking the these energy operators and manufacturers on the same platform. Then it could be possible, because they should be in line with the manufacturers, na? Plugging in all the things. Then so they are, we are thinking about that. Government of India is thinking in that. In that way, the cost will drastically down.
And there will be monopoly of single platform only. There will be monopoly of
the same company. There are a lot of the company like Mahindra, Tata, Volkswagen, something.
Yeah, this is the battery.
Then
if
they go to
more company, then they will not get better with other company,
right? Energy operator will be defined by the manufacturers. This is the Volkswagen energy operator. This is Mahindra energy operator. He is like this kind of the things will be. So it may also be possible in future once this will come. So,
gas.
Right. So in future it can be. First we have to step one. Then we will move ahead. One more possibility is that just discharge battery, you can just go in some charge environment 20 degrees Celsius where the battery life will be increased. So in that case also we can go and do. So as I told that fast charging I have already discussed. In India there is a problem of the charging. So the one more thing that I want to discuss, that suppose EV. So I've just here case study, I have made a case study in city generally 100 kilometers in a whole day, we just move, go here and there. So it is sufficient 200 watt hour per kilometer. So you can move 100 kilometer for as a e-car, 30 to 50 kilowatt hour battery. So 90% of the day, you whatever the your desire needs, it will be filled by this EV. But in night, you can charge by your slow chargers at home, 16 ampere. So swapping kind of things also possible. So this is the institutions, government institution who are working. So Department of Heavy Industries is responsible for these standards and other things. They are also providing the incentives, and this NTPC, they are regulating the powers and other things. So all the ministry have some responsibility, but no one is stopping doing the research kind of things. So mostly the research DST, Ministry Department of Heavy Industry and Ministry of Electronics IT, they are providing funds for the research in electric vehicle. So this is the future R&D and startup opportunity here. That is motor development, battery cell development, battery charger, air conditioner, system controller. So skills, EV skill centers should be also be set up in collaboration with the industry so that the this manpower will be generated in this area also. These are the some companies which are working in EV vehicles, Ashok Leyland, mostly they are Indian company. And lithium ion battery recycling, XI, Amar Raja, they are working on that. So recycling plant has been recently set up by the Amar Raja, very big plant. So these are the energy operators, the government of India thinking that to convert NTPC, PGCIL. So they are working on that. So, and charger motors. So these are the Ministry of Electronics and IT. There are some projects has been funded. That is done by that is being done by Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala. That is the I'm saying that these are the collaboration. So just see here for development. What we I'm discussing so for any proposal. So actually I'm in last two or three slides. So for any actual proposal, just see in the proposal, there is one institute, IIT Madras. Along with that, lot of the industries there. So you have to collaborate with the industry. And we are moving with the collaboration kind of thing. You will be the, there are three entity will come on the same platform. You as a R&D institute will design the things, right? Then suppose you are designing the motor. You will design on computer, everything you have simulated, you find it is okay, right? Then manufacture, and how you will design based on the specification of the manufacturer of the motor. How the manufacturer got this order from the vehicle manufacturer, right? Vehicle manufacturer, na? Vehicle manufacturer, suppose Tata bola ki mere ko 2 kilowatt ka motor chahiye, uska power itna hona chahiye, torque itna hona chahiye. Then he will tell to the this motor manufacturer. Then motor manufacturer aapke paas aayega. Uske paas suppose R&D team utni nahi hai, wo nahi kar sakta. He is importing the IP from outside. So aap uske liye aap motor us performance ka aap bana ke denge. So there are three entities. One is the design and development. Second is the manufacturer. Third is the vehicle, where the, our motor will be used by right? User. Got. So we just floated the call for proposal for the motor and controller. So these three institutions come with the industry. In the industry, some of the manufacturer of the motor controller, some is the fused, I think, this vehicle users like Lohia Auto, Goneka Electric. So in this, like MicroSpin and other, they are motor manufacturers. And Lohia will use in their vehicle. So such kind of the project you have to think. And you have to collaborate with the industry. In general, in ministry, we will only tell in the call for proposal that we just want the proposal in collaboration with the industry for the manufacturing of motor, controller, for any capacity. चाहे आप 2 kilowatt का बनाइए, 100 kilowatt, 50 kilowatt, कुछ भी बनाइए, बट उसका कोई आगे लेके जाना होना चाहिए, right? It is not like that, just all the research in the laptop only. Your research go outside. This is the current mandate of the government in every, not only in the in electric vehicle, everywhere. It should be the result of your research should come in the society.
The commercialization.
If you are not able to actually earlier, what will happen in last 10 days, 10 years, 10 to 15 years, only floated for the infrastructure development of the institutions. They have not come up with the I think in last 5 years I have data around 50,000 crore has been spent, but no single technology come in the market that 50,000 crore. Now government have a clear mandate that if you are using the government money for R&D, it should be commercialized anyhow. If you require more money, we will give more money. There is no issue of money, but a good collaboration with the industry is required to go the product what you are developing into the market, into the society. This is the clear mandate. If you have, you are working with us. That's why you just initiate to talking to the industry, relevant industry. Because without industry, we generally not give the proposals. In that proposals, what you are, you also given this refinery and other institutions, they have come up with the industry also. Although they are not doing much, because we have the sub corner some here in the rural area like Eastern UP, right? Actually, if you see the trend of the research, so most of the funds of the government of India is going to the this west south.
Yes,
so
because most of the industry are situated there, and that is why they can easily viable and easily approach and it should make a.
This is the one thing, but problem is that here in the in Eastern UP, generally they are not serious.
Mm-hmm. This is the one of the most important.
This happened. That's while giving to the proposal last year. It is off the line,
Yes, sir. No.
It is online. I hope. Okay. Now, if anyone have any question, you can ask. I hope lots of faculty, sir. All the faculty nearly are the fresher, and they don't know how we can apply for the project proposal. I request you, please give the entire the sequence how we can apply for the project.
Right.
Now this. No, yeah, but I say discuss. Kare, I'm calling.